Yeah, they do take it out.
It's a comfort hero, I guess, as well. You want to put your enemy team off their comfort zone.
Yeah, they could have first picked it, though, is the
yes.
thing. And not have a Shadow Demon in return.
They still take out the Slaughter. This opens up VP because they've got the second pick here. So they can pick up that combination we were wondering about. Like, what happens if the Ember gets through? What happens where the Juggernaut gets through? What happens where all these other like great safe laners, which Ramses is really solid on, get through?
Yeah. I don't know if they want to first pick Ember, just because the Centaur really enabled the Ember. Like, if there wasn't a Centaur in the game, I think Ember would have just continued to do nothing in team fights.
But that's also because they picked an Ember into a Nyx Assassin.
Yeah,
like,
that's
that
true.
Was, like, he was already instantly countered. So now the Ember comes up, so VP have the choice. If they want to flag up the Nyx again...
They might try the Ursa. I really did like the way that DC used the Ursa to counter the Ember Spirit. I just don't know if it's the no one type of hero in mid. He's like way more the like sniper, Shadow Fiend type of player.
They could always try to switch it up. They don't do it very often, but Ramses does play Ursa.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, now
but he also plays Draw Ranger.
He's most definitely the Draw Ranger in this one. Like, the only thing which could change up here is potentially like with a solo taking the Disruptor, you actually finally get Lil's Visage. But his team doesn't like drafting it for him.
It's deemed a little bit weak, but I like this counter for the Ember Spirit a little bit more than the Dispel. The Dispel only gets rid of the Flame Guard. It doesn't actually kill the Ember. Long duration silences kill Ember, and Disruptor and Draw Ranger have very long duration silences.
This also opens up the mid lane for no one to be a lot stronger. You look to OG's bans in the second phase, and what are you gonna take out both SF as well as Invoker going into this next phase? This is still going to leave your Templar Assassin. It's going to leave the aggressive heroes we were looking for in the mid lane to work.
I still like Invoker, I think, personally, just for the lane control. I think it offers a lot more lane control than the TA. TA versus Ember is a skill-based matchup, and I think that...
But OG's not going to let that through. Like,
I don't think they care that much.
Having the Invoker versus Ember before.
I don't think they care that much because they can just dump Darkseer in the off lane, and then they roam mid a lot more. So like the even one-on-one matches, I think favors OG because they make sure that Ana succeeds far more often than VP. Make sure that no one succeeds.
Maybe that's when we look to VP support banning out to the next phase then. Look towards that Earth Spirit, which is still in the pool. The good rotation heroes that you said, like, that can work in the mid lane.
The Jerax heroes.
Yeah, and Speak of the Devil, that's exactly what they pick up.
Yep, well, there it is. So what are Virtus Pro's bans going to be centered around now? Are you going to try to ban out some of No-Tails ones?
You could probably, like, start to restrict S4's maneuver. Mm-hmm. Draw Ranger's normally pretty good up against, like, heavy melee-style heroes. Just because she just loves it with the early cold arrows. A lot of Draw Rangers have been actually prioritizing getting cold arrows, almost at like getting level 4 on the cold arrows nice and early, because it's just too easy to kill the offlaners once you hit level 6. And with a little bit of help from Disruptor, it makes it way too easy.
Hello, Glimpse.
Yeah.
So, Terrorblade.
I still think Warlock's a big deal.
Warlock makes a big deal as well?
I think it works really well against the style that Draw Ranger plays. Like, Fatal Bonds, she can't really play super offensively, and the Rock is also particularly good.
That's a good ban out for the offlaner. Draw Ranger Silas never lasts long enough to actually kill off the Brewmaster.
I think Disruptor ulti is pretty good versus it, but I think they might just be scared of...
You've got too many things to catch inside of that now.
Yeah.
I'm also wondering what VP do in the offlane. Like, I kind of like the Darkseer to start with, but now I start to question it. The synergy isn't really that terrific with both the Draw and Disruptor.
Clock, I think, would be pretty good, but Pasha doesn't actually play it that often.
Mm-hmm. I think OG are actually more on the money to take out that Omni Knight. That would have been a really nice one. That would have given VP a little bit more sustain, so they can force the team fights a little bit earlier on and push with the Draw Ranger, which is obviously what you always want to do with such a hero.
So is Darkseer there for out of the question? Does it take too long for him to start contributing?
I don't like Darkseer Draw Ranger, personally.
Yeah,
it just doesn't work out well, it seems.
The Darkseer kind of really... He works more when you run melee cores. And when you're on a Draw Range, you're already thinking like a range hero for mid. And no one will probably want to run a range hero anyway up against the Ember Spirit. Unless he gets the DK, like the hybrid kind of style.
I also think Draw Ranger and Darkseer both work better when there's someone else starting off the fight. Like, you don't really want to start off a fight with a vacuum wall. You wait a little bit into the fight, and Draw Ranger, you just can't start off the fight with her. So
actually banned the Darkseer. Darkseer is one of those heroes that Draw actually likes to fight up against.
It's so. It's really strong with the Ember Spirit. Like, Ember Spirit with Ion Shell up in Draw Ranger's face is definitely not a good thing for Drow.
The only reason why I flag like it's good for the Drow is the fact that it keeps pushing the wave back underneath your tier 1 tower, and with consistent DPS you can actually get like really, really easy last hits and a rather quick level 6.
Yeah, past the laning phase I think is a lot of trouble though. Drow Ranger doesn't really like her lanes pushed, and she likes to be the one pushing in the lanes.
Yeah.
Yeah, and looking at counter push so far, OG only have that Ember Spirit. So they might want some extra if they are expecting Virtus.pro to make a move early, depending, of course, well, mostly what their mid laner is going to be. And it will be the Batrider for a 9 Pasha.
Well, you asked someone to do the initiation for you. Batrider is it.
Yep.
Yeah, they have a ton of lockdown versus the Ember Spear. Also, most of the save heroes are out. Shadow Demon's out. I really dislike Dazzle versus Disruptor and Batrider. Like, they both usually just die immediately after the grave, so I think Dazzle's kind of out of the question here. And then Omni Knight's also taken out.
You could run Nyx's Assassin, which would be really nice right now for OG's offlane.
Yeah, Nyx's Assassin, I think, would still be pretty good for them.
He's not that great in the offlane for escaping from a Disruptor. That's his only downside, but with rotations in from an Ember, or potentially just like just messing with the Batrider in the mid game, if he can survive the early game with enough levels, then he'll be really, really good against VP.
I think that our lanes are going to really struggle, though, with the Nyx Assassin. You have 3 melee in all the lanes, and then you have Drow Ranger on the opposite side, too, and they haven't determined their mid laner yet.
But what else are you going to run? Like, it's...
Centaur, I think, is pretty good. Crimson Guard Centaur is really good against dealing with a Drow Ranger. Mm-hmm. Just run at him with Crimson Guard. Pretty good.
True. At the same time, if you don't have your Stampede up, then Drow kills you in the offlane.
Yeah, and that is a problem.
And you will become food.
It's a little tough.
I wonder if this is actually a 1 or a 5.
I would say way more likely to be a 1. And very good counter versus the Batrider. You don't really need defensive support if you have Venge.
That's the reason why I'm wondering if you question if it's a 5 or a 1. Like, the 5 is just like the straight-up counter to the Batrider.
Yeah, I guess it could be either.
Where the 1 becomes like, I need to be tanky enough, like I need to get that early Dragonlance so I can fight against the Batrider. God, if VP actually pick up a Visage as the last one, then this is the perfect VP lineup. Even though Visage isn't the perfect hero, it's the perfect VP lineup.
Well, the Invoker will be there again against the Ember Spirit. Hopefully having a little bit more success this time. Although it will be tricky with the Ember Spirit rotating around.
They may need a little bit of tank. The survivability of VP is actually quite terrible at the moment.
How are you going to fix that with the 4 position?
I think Quaswex is actually okay versus Ember Spirit, Ember Spirit roam. If you roll, you just Tornado and just run away. It's not really that big a deal. So Slark is pretty good versus the Batrider, and also a decent hero to deal with the Drow Ranger, but there is a big downside to the Slark. Firstly, they have no tower hitters. Every single drive that we've seen from OG has had Terror Blade, you know, Luna generally, some sort of hero that could just wail on towers. They don't have anything that can hit towers, which is very atypical for their lineup. And secondly, Slark is very slow-paced versus a Drow Ranger. Slark generally just has way less farm than a Drow, at least first 30 minutes of the game, and oftentimes you just can't stay in the middle of a fight. But it is very, very good in the laning phase versus Batrider and in the mid-game versus Bat.
They banned the Magnus as the last one. I was actually wondering, too, where OG's counter-push is. I know that was something which we were kind of harping on in the previous matches, where we were just like, okay, where is that? What stops the push from Virtus.pro when they bring in the Drow range, when Invoker is able to pick up a couple of levels? Ember's able to do it, but only when he comes online. Slark's able to do it when he's able to be aggressive enough.
Yeah, their anti-push is actually quite terrible.
Yeah. So if VP actually gets something even more aggressive, like, I'm not going to say, you know, well, Chen was one of the options, but I was like, they're not going to pick up a Jakiro or something like this. They could force the lanes down so heavily that both Ember and Slark are just going to be scrambling to find farm. And if that Slark doesn't get a Shadow Blade before that timing hits, then OG are in a lot of trouble. But if the Batrider gets caught out, if Slark's able to get the good leashes off and the good rotations from the Earth Spirit, then as VP, you, I think, is going to be in more trouble. They're going to get picked off on multiple lanes.
Damn, Mag would have been a good pick. There's not that many other good offlaners for...
Is Legion Commander good enough?
I think it's very good versus the Batrider. I'm just scared for their teamfight. Like, their teamfight's really weak. It's just Earth Spirit. Like, I don't even think they need Lasso to win the teamfights with this. Like, you don't even need to use it. You just Firefly, Napalm, and kind of go in.
There's a bit more deep push with this, though.
Yeah, I do like it for the deep push. But, like, AoE control, it's only Earth Spirit in this. So VP just need one more support to round things out.
Yeah, you said you wanted to have a little bit more of a beefy support or something that could...
Vista is just fine if you mentioned...
Yeah, Vista should be fine. I'm actually leaning more back towards the Rubik. Someone that can stop the Legion Commander that's while she's actually inside of her duel, and it's another one of those like really good initiations you get from the support. So Strup's kind of like that pull-back style hero. It gives you a little bit of counter push yourself by having the Fey Bolt. And it's another good controller too. Like Legion Commander on the offlane, she gets gusted, she gets cold arrowed. Like this is gonna be really hard for her. Like she tries to break free to run away, but then you got telekinesis to go all over again. So yeah, Legion's nice, but I think VP can find a lot of strength out of their lineup. But it's still one of those things, right? Like if their laning phase can survive whatever VP throws at them, their transition into mid game is gonna be so powerful. The VP is just gonna become food on legs.
Yep. That is the scary part. Well, they have to choose, and there it is. It is a Sand King. Does that make that Batrider support?
I think more likely that Sand King is going to be support. I don't know. Sand King's much better in the lane versus Slark, so I think if they want to do that matchup, it would be completely justified.
And with four melee healers, it does lean towards SK being that. But then what are you going to do? Throw Batrider into the jungle from the very start?
Yeah.
It's not unheard of at all.
It's been pretty popular, actually, the support. Straight up jungle Batrider. It's been
especially
very successful.
Yeah. Lil does Lil things, and I think he can do that on a Batrider as well. So, are we going to see a third game? Is the question.
Overall, I think I like VP's lineup a little bit more. Even though it's like a little bit more old school, I think it has a lot more pieces well put together. Whereas I think OG strayed away from their having a heavy tower hitter on No Tail, and I don't think they're going to come online fast enough to deal with the draw.
So yeah, I'm actually thinking VP's laning phase now with this Batrider. Like, if it pays off, then yeah, VP can get ahead. But I'm kind of like leaning the opposite direction than I was in game one. I actually think OG actually have a lot more strength going into the mid game, and they're going to survive the early game with just really good positioning and really good coordination.
Well, we are soon heading over to our commentators, but any like type of timings that we can look out for this match that, you know, could really break or make the game for a team?
Timings?
I kind of want to watch to see the Invoker's timings.
Yes.
To see how good of an early game he has, to see how quickly he gets that hand of Midas. Like, if we see that Midas around that 10, 12 minute mark, then I'm actually, like that is going to be really, really good for him. And the movement from VP is going to be really nice.
Okay, I believe we do have a game underway, although we are still having another pause, so we don't have the game underway. I lied. I'm sorry, guys. Ben, in terms of timings for you, anything that you feel like that Sand King needs to be able to do to be having a good game for Virtus Pro?
I think he's kind of... It's always based around Drow Ranger and how fast you can push. I think just how many towers they can take down before Slark gets his first item, whether it is Blink or Shadowblade. Mostly Shadowblade nowadays, but...
Yeah, if he's able to pick that up, but it's at least like if they put the Batrider inside the jungle, they're not going to get the free kills from picking up the Batrider on the offlane. SK is a lot more elusive when he's on that offlane, unless they bring a lot of detection down the bottom lane, and then it's going to be a very different kettle of fish.
Yeah, we are told that the pause will last a little bit longer, so bear with us, guys, as we are waiting here for game two of Virtus Pro versus OG. And, you know, we are kind of split on how this will go. The previous game already showed that it was very 50-50 in terms of result. It could have gone either way, and I think this game will prove that it's just a very close matchup overall. Previous game, we liked the draft of Virtus Pro a little bit more as well, maybe just like this game, but that game had OG with the team fight that just, you know, it was dominant from them. The coordination was just there, and something that maybe Virtus Pro lacked a little bit.
Yeah. Want to see if they can do it again?
Want to see if they're doing it again? I think this time we are actually here for game number two, Virtus Pro OG with OD Pixel and Gods.
Thank you very much, Shiva. Indeed, we're ready to get ourselves stuck into game two, OG versus Virtus Pro. And we're already kicking off already. We're seeing a bit of a couple there down on the bottom lane between Solo and Flyers. They're eyeing each other up as the lane starts coming to fruition. We are seeing at the moment S4 being backed up by Jax and Anna looking to contest this top bounty room potentially over the side of VP. Ramses will be indeed up on the top lane, and it is, of course, going to be Lil on that kind of support bat, Pasha on the core Sand King. I mean, a lot of interesting things coming out from both drafts here. Gods, I mean, No Tail Slark, a little bit of a treat. Do you kind of like OG's approach towards this VP Drow strat that they're bringing out?
They've picked well against it. They've got good gap closes with Slark, Ember, Earth Spirit. and even Legion can get in your face. Legion very tanky. We see that here. Legion already looking to Drow's face. And S4 securing the Bounty Rune against Ramsey's up top. Small little win for OG to start things off, but overall, I like the move from VP to say this bat as a core isn't going to work as well. Let's pick up a Sand King as our key initiator because the lasso is not going to be reliable against both the Venge swap as well as the press the attack from Legion Commander. So they want to make sure they had a second more reliable initiator, and that's where they get the Sand King and put him as a core in a very good matchup against Slark.
And as the lane starts to settle off, Jarex at the moment will be sitting up top with S4. Do you feel that S4 needs the presence of Jarex here, or can we expect Jarex just to be incredibly mobile, look towards helping out the mid lane as well? What's the plan for the Earth Spirit in this early game?
Yeah, he needs to just secure S4 his early levels more than anything. He's being up here means S4 won't Disrupt get ganked. If he's not up here, Disruptor just walks up to S4, keeps on spamming Thunderstrike, right-clicking him, but you can't do that alone when there's an Earth Spirit up here because you get rolled on and S4 will just run at you and start right-clicking you and suddenly you're in trouble. So it means VP have to commit the Batrider to the top lane, and it just kind of turns into this domino effect where by having Earth Spirit up top, it means that the Batrider can't jungle. He has to go top as well, so it keeps VP busy and it also guarantees S4 some decent early game last hits.
Jarek's laying down the stone, just
that's
making
like a,
sure.
Hello, I'm
yeah,
here.
Yeah, absolutely. Just
it's not even looking to make a roll. Get it on cooldown, he knows he's going to have another stone soon enough anyways.
Right, trying to go for the side pull here, we'll catch the range creep. Able to starting to disrupt the flow of the lane, VP as well, so they're just making the small camp pulls. And mid lane, Lil. I mean, this is annoying to say the least here for the Ember Spirit. Level 1 bat, just sitting mid, spamming the napalm onto you.
Yeah. It's definitely pesky. He'll keep him at his tower. Lil doing a good job. Bottom line, Notel and Pasha trading a lot of hits, but this is Notel doing a really good job of harassing early on. He's got 4 denies. He does take a lot of damage here and needs to make sure he gets his salve up. May actually go down. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Not enough punches.
It was doing a great job until suddenly he got overwhelmed by a caustic.
Top lane though, OG looks to make a return play, trying to make Ramses pay. He can't quite get the final touch in. In fact, the turnaround, the Thunderstrike bringing Jarex low. S4 trying to finish off solo. Again, a lot of damage being done with it. The Newt nearly getting a double kill there. Solo and Ramses just living by the skin of their teeth.
We're going to tango that tree.
Jarex, oh, he's going to YOLO in. Lord help, Jarex just mans up, throws his life away, but it's absolutely worth it. As he takes down Ramses on a bit of a suicide mission, God.
Interesting. well worth it.
Get the
XP. Yep, get the carry. Why the hell not? Pasha's made a move now towards mid. He's looking for Ana. This is
early rotation.
There's Cold Snap. There's not a whole lot of mana on Invoker, but perhaps with the Batrider's presence, yeah. With Batrider coming, this could
Look
be
at
the
this.
Kill.
I mean, Ana could not have expected this one. Pasha rotating in 2.5 minutes. They surround the Ember Spirit. Ana trying to get himself out with the stick charges. It is not going to be enough as he's slowed down by the napalm. Pasha, I mean, he certainly made the rotations in the last game with the Nyx Assassin, but a little later on, this game already kind of showing the hate for the Ember Spirit.
I mean, that's like such an efficient play because he rotates for the Shrine as well. So not only does he get a kill, he comes along for the Shrine. They also still have the other Shrine available. So if VP make an aggressive play, like we're often seeing these like 6 to 8 minute mark, let's contest the offlane, send 2 or 3 heroes down there, get a kill.
Top lane, Jarex ready to go. They smoked up the two of them there. Jarex and Fly getting into position, allowing them to again to get another kill onto Ramses in this early stage of the game, killing him twice so far. Three and a half minutes in, it's already turning out a bit of a bloodbath between the two sides.
Yeah, no, get most of the pull at the top lane, not all of it. Again, they're trying to deny as much XP and farm as possible from Ramses. Pasha's had a very good start on the Sand King. Apart from the CS, even though he got a first blood, but he's got 2 CS. He just got his second CS that second. So despite even pushing Notel out of the lane, he wasn't able to pick up a whole lot of farm on himself. This bottom lane, I was going to commend Notel because he's done incredibly well laning-wise in a tough matchup.
Oh, top lane again. Jarex going in, kicking Ramses back into the hands of Fly, and they'll take him down once again. OG. Yeah, pulling the hate out against this Drow and absolutely crushing him in the laning stage, guys.
There's There's a reason Jerix is the probably most feared spirit player out there, and he's showing it up top. Getting the roll in and then using the kick to push Drow out of position. Rather than going for the stun, he wants to make sure Ramzes is suddenly surrounded by 2-3 heroes, and we've seen it a couple times now. Where Jerix has been able to set up that kill up in the top lane. And that is 3 kills due to the Earth Spirit and 3 kills all on the Drow Ranger.
And mid lane, VP in return going back in on Ana. So at the moment, certainly feels like VP. They're saying throw everything at Ana, and OG is saying throw everything at Ramzes. And again, this top lane, S4 is getting a little cocky. It feels rather strong. Level 5 at the moment for the 5-minute mark.
This Legion Commander hero, when you get phase boots at this stage, you pop an overwhelming odds and you have, like, you get your max movement speed. You're also just so tanky with the poor man shield, 900 HP, a lot of damage block, potential to heal yourself, as well as take off the Thunderstrike. There is no killing S4 with 2 heroes. With 3, things get a bit more possible, but even 3, I don't know if they can kill S4.
Very, very hard to do so. Especially now with Fly back in the neighborhood, hanging out behind him, bottom lane. Jerax, seeing if he can maybe set up some action here for Notel, if he can find a lock onto Pasha. Yeah, initiation from Notel, starting to play around. Notel has to be careful, falling incredibly low, but it does work. The bait's successful, Pasha sticks around too long, and Jerax once again setting up a kill for the team. Top lane, S4 goes immediately in with the jewel with a backup, but Fly should be enough damage to find one. In fact, he's even looking about setting up maybe onto a second. Magic missiles onto Lil, he's up into the trees, but Fly's right clicks here, bringing him down low. S4 turns his attention back towards Solo. There is now backup as Pasha TPing across, looking towards S4. S4 hitting a good nuke, bring them down low. The burrow strikes in. Jerax again! He's turned up to the fight every time. Jerax just moving in. It doesn't get him a kill onto these two. On the sidelines, Fly was able to finish off the Batrider. Now TP's out. He's not going to make it. The burrow strike will be there as VP punish him. But again, I mean, Jerax, he's having a great start. 2-1-2. He's all around the map. They did get that kill on the bat. Fly's fine with his life being thrown away.
That fight chased the bat all the way through the trees to get a... That's a solo kill for a support Venge. 5 position. Suddenly gets up to level 4.5. Managed to get boots, raindrops, a magic stick. That's the kind of farm you don't expect to have as a Venge at 6.5 minutes in the game. So well worth it to chase for that kill in Fly's position. And he's ready to make another move. He's got a smoke in hand, probably going to smoke up with Jerax here and try and set up a kill either around the mid lane or the bottom lane, wherever they feel they can have the highest impact. And they are being very effective with their early game moves on the OG supports.
Jerax nearly level 5 as well, 7 minutes in. Absolutely fantastic for this roaming Earth Spirit. Let's see what they can get. They've got a good scam. They know that someone's here. It's actually Ramzes who's had to leave that top lane and gone to the safety, quote-unquote, of his own jungle away from these two. But Fly and Jerax, they're just hunting him down constantly across the map. He'll try and run. He'll try and hide. Fly just needs one more touch. They've got the boulder smash as well from Jerax just to secure the lockdown.
I feel like they've got a good escape.
Can they get out? Yeah, Pasha and Lil and Noah, they're looking to avenge this. They will find Fly. Jerax is out, but he is going to have to leave Fly behind.
Yeah, Fly buys up. He's spent most of his money. And yeah, he spent all his money, at least the unreliable.
Notel, what are we going on here? Ramzes moving in as well. Notel should be fine. Pounce is out. Still has the Shadow Dance if necessary, and it's not top lane. The S4 came in quite quickly, trying to see if we get a bit of a play onto Solo. Just putting the pressure on, as you mentioned earlier, just with his early phase boots. Running around. No one's actually TP'd across in reaction. Chasing S4 away from this top lane. That's the cold snap, but they don't really have too much of a gap closer, and Anna's there as well in terms of backup. 7-6, though. That's a lot happening so far in this early game.
And with all the pressure they're putting on, Ember's been able to have a decent time in the mid lane, and Ramzes, again, finding himself getting gone on. Ramzes has had the worst early game you can really imagine as a Drow Ranger. 5 deaths in 8 minutes. Oh boy. This is quite a change from his last game as Luna. And they see him. They want to go on him again. Not letting him farm up even safety camp deep on his side of the map.
Looks like they may settle for Pasha. As they will hunt him down in the tree line. Jayne's into the silence once again. Jerax just allowing the chance for them to finish him off. No chance of a burrow strike. Oh, I say that. He does get it off, but it's almost certainly still down. Fly didn't see him there. And in fact, oh, the infused rain drops. He's only going to have one of them as the charge still cooling down. Won't save him for the second. Bit of burst. OG, 8-6.
He's going to live quite some time and create some space for at least something to be gained elsewhere on the map, but that something doesn't really include the Drow, who's forced to go full jungle. Ramses is... this is better than what was happening before, but he's still got no treads, 9 minutes in the game. Barely level 6.
Second lowest on the net worth.
Jeez, that's rough. This bat, someone needs to get a blink soon to help make some plays and moves to VP, be it the Sand King or the Batrider. They just need that blink so they can kind of create some space for Ramses to play catch-up mode. Solo looking for his level 6 in the top lane, has been given the lane. It's a very dangerous, like, if Drow goes up to that top lane, she's going to die, so they just give it to Solo and let the Drow get the safer farm in the jungle. And then if Solo can get level 6, he can smoke up with his team, make a move.
S4, blink dagger complete, 10 minute mark. Level 8 as well, reaching onto level 9. Just at the net worth of S4 on par with that of Notel. Yeah, Notel's been having free farm. S4, he's been involved in the kills. 1-0-4 thanks to just how well that top lane went. And a lot of that largely down to the rotations of Jerax, and obviously backed up by Fly as well. These two just had caused absolute havoc in that top lane, and there's no stopping them now. Jerax and Fly looking to continue the momentum with S4. And you kind of have to feel for Ramses here, surely. Yeah, he's... if they find him out now. I mean, it looks like they're not going to move into the jungle. They're maybe looking to see if anyone TP's down towards the mid lane, whereas some VP themselves are actually looking for a play on the bottom. They're not going to find anyone, though. Notel safely farming in his own jungle. And OG will start now to hunt through the jungle of VP. But Ramses just hugging the tree line behind his towers.
Good read from both Dyer's carry players, Notel and Ramses, well aware that...
you say that, but Notel's just wore right into them.
It's okay. Oh, he didn't get the ulti off.
He jinxed him, gods.
Went for the dark pact instead of the ulti. He was farming very defensively, and then suddenly took a little roam through his jungle. But Ramses knows what's happening. Fortunately, he has no TP.
And mid lane as well, Anna. Will be last, so they don't have quite enough lockdown. And he does get himself out.
Slightly not catching him with the glimpse back. So such a short distance, he couldn't get it with the remnant. Ramses is trapped. That courier is flying up there. They may see it. Oh no, do they know?
They pinged it. They pinged it. They know. They know he's there. Oh. They know he's going for it.
The way,
can they hunt him out?
I think he's okay. He can TP deep. Yeah,
he should be out in time. They will still see if they can sweep the area for him, but he's already safely out. As you will realize that. Yeah, they're pinging him immediately. Yeah. So, he's over there, boys.
But now they've got a very deep ward on this top lane in the jungle. They've fully taken over this top side of the map, really, and they can use this to try to find some more kills for themselves. They'd like to get some more jewels damage for S4, ideally. And with the Venge as a partner, S4 definitely has what it takes to find some kills up here.
Jarrett's level 6, so he needs to be careful of him.
Don't think he wants to go for the solo kill there, but...
yeah, they see, of course, as you mentioned, with that ward, all this backup coming in from VP. So OG will be careful about how they go about fighting around this top lane.
Nice ward from Solo, smokes up, goes down river, gets that ward to help protect their jungle at top a bit and even perhaps set up later on for a bit of a push. Say that, it doesn't really feel like a VP draft that's going to hit a timing with Drow at this point to go for any kind of a big push.
No tell. Back to getting the space on the bottom. As he works towards his Echo Saber, pretty much done as well.
They're hunting so much. Jerix is like rolling out of the trees up top. Does roll into a range creep, but they were really trying to catch out someone like the Drow up top. And Ramsey, yeah, not having any of it. Back in the jungle once again. But this is creating a lot of space for Notel.
Radiant's middle tower.
But for the first item, Echo Saber, as opposed to the Shadow Blade. Build which gives him, I mean, just the better stats overall. More of a pseudo farming item rather than, you go into the Shadow Blade, then you're kind of put in that position where you like want to be making sure you get kills now, and you're versing a team which has some pretty good counter maneuvers for a Slark, so going for a slightly safer build.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Echo dump for Nota. No one has finally got that Midas complete, and at the same time, Pasha, Blink Dagger out on the Sand King, so. Considering how the way that the game's going, very considerable timing for Pasha.
He pops the smoke with the invis. And there's
they don't
no
have
detection.
Any detection. No sentries at the moment. And now actually pop out of it, though. Into the midst of it all, but there is backup from the side of OG. Jax looking to roll forward. There's the silence onto Lil Magnetize as well. Duel from the sidelines. S4 catches out the escape. Can he get the kill? He will. We had to get themselves the bonus damage. They're taking three down on VP. May have lost Anna, but again, they're finding very much the favorable trades here.
Yeah. Anna probably didn't have to die for that fight to go as well as it did, but he thought he could burst the disruptor before he'd get silence there. Just didn't quite manage to pull it off. Went for a play. And I mean, his team win the fight regardless, so it's not like a bad outcome for them, but perhaps the better outcome, of course, involving the Ember Spirit not dying. Dire's middle but tower even so, S4 gets the dual damage, Slark getting involved as well. He's at the top lane, top net worth, really just trying to pressure these lanes as much as possible. And Anna's just going to go back to farming now. Wants that boot to travel probably as fast as possible.
Yeah, Anna already starting to pick the pace back up. You know, did suffer at the start. There were a few kind of rotations that caught him off guard in that early laning stage. And now just 300 behind the Invoker.
Yep. He's got the spell damage out now on his talent, so he can offer a bit more. But overall, it feels like OG just coming together very nicely here in the early game with the support movements, and then follow that up with their core starting to deliver. The Legion Commander S4 again, picking up where he left off last game, being that big problem player, creating space, finding those get key initiations, getting pickoffs, and Nurtel not going for his Shadow Blade, going for the Blink, the more guaranteed initiation and gap-closing item. If you go for the Shadow Blade and they have sentries, you walk into a Gust, you walk into a Lasso or a Sand King Burrow Strike. There's so many things which can punish a Slark if he tries to Shadow Blade in. The Blink is actually going to be a more reliable item choice this game. And I like the choice from Notel. VP, though, making the right moves. They see Heroes top, they take bottom. They may lose a tier 2 for a tier 1, but they're the ones who are behind on farm and items. They're not really ready to fight. This feels like at least making the best of a bad situation.
Yeah, absolutely. Certainly not in kind of the shape to tackle a team fight head on with OG. So any trade is a good trade, as you said, considering their position at the moment in this game.
And just get some wards down here at the bottom jungle as well. Not as deep as perhaps they would have liked, but I mean, with all this happening, it's OG continuing to kind of pull further and further ahead. Bit by bit. And they'll be ready to probably make some more smoke maneuvers fairly soon. They're grouping up. That's what they want to do right now. The Legion Commander probably thirsty to get some more damage up. And there we go. Another smoke coming in.
Nice towards Ninetail solo. He's going to find him here. He will go for the trap. And in fact, the Static Storm does get him knocked out, though, by the Flame Break. He's going to be fine. And a good combo indeed. Jerax just coming in, shutting down the entire team. Breland down low. Duel onto Ramses. That's one out with no one. Trying to get himself away with the Ghost Walk. They've got a sentry out there on the top. Pasha is able to come with the Epicenter. Is it enough to finish off? I don't know. S4 with the heal, saving Anna. And again, we've seen this before. Fly just chasing down Lil across the fire. Fly, he does not care about walking across the flames.
He's
finding even more again with the Magnetize onto two. They're having to tuck their tails and run. Can S4 pick up the kill? That's the question, no one. Yeah, see, actually, maybe able to turn it with Pasha hitting the Burrow Strike.
He's got a nuke soon, so
they've got to be careful, yeah. Jerax.
Respawn's coming in, though, so OG do not want to overstay their welcome, and they managed to get out before anyone can come in to punish them. And great teamfight. Jerax hitting a four-man silence into a four-man boulder smasher at like at least three or four. It was, again, the Earth Spirit genius pulling up, coming up big. And they four-man shrine, they're ready to go right back into the enemy jungle, I imagine. Ideally, they'd like to do so with a smoke, and that is... They've got a blink dagger, though, so that'll perhaps be a nice alternative for them. A lot of their vision in that enemy jungle has been taken away, but it's still a very dominant OG position here.
Yeah, for sure. Each fight kind of just showing that, you know, VP, even though they get these ults off, we saw there, you know, Pasha gets at the epicenter, but the fact that Ember Spirit kill just slips away from him. Very painful for VP. They need to be able to take down these cores at this stage. We saw at the start in the laning, they were able to gank, they were able to shut down Ember early on, but now Anna setting up the ranks.
Notel just sweeping on through. This is kind of like, let's check where their wards are as Wallace set up some kills, and hello.
So jumping straight in. Standing Storm will be laid down, but I guess at this point, Notel doesn't really care. Got the Shadow Dance off in time. Nice burrow strike onto two, but the backup's there from the rest of OG. Notel jumps in, takes down the Power Rider, and OG, get a catch on anything else. There'll be a good Tornado holding them back, but Notel on the side picks up the Disruptor. Double kill for the Slark. Notel just getting bigger and bigger this game. 9k net worth. And immediately going into the BKB as well, and if he gets that at the kind of rate he's going to get it, looking at the farm pace that he's had so far, there's just going to be no way that VP can hold him back.
Just baits so many spells. He just goes leaping in, latches on, he forces out a Burrow Strike and a Static Storm, and he just knows instantly ulti so he doesn't die.
Yeah.
And even if he doesn't get kills during that ultimate, he's still forced out the key VP teamfight winning spells, and they haven't won a teamfight off of them, they just put them on cooldown. And OG know that that follow-up fight is going to be one. Jerick swoops in and again hits a multiple hero stun, silence. It's a thing of beauty.
Okay, right, so as you've seen, two goes in at the same time here. Towards the mid lane, there'll be the duel. S4 is caught out, Lil. That'll be an extra bit of bonus damage in the pocket of him. Anna remnanting forward aggressively. There'll be a tornado, but Notel dart packs it off. The chains connect, and VP, they're going to lose heavy casualties here. Ramses, can he get himself out? Looks like he had with Pasha coming in with a big plays. Ramses trying to turn, but the nuke's there from S4. He jumps in, four dead on VP. They're going to lose five. It's a full team wipe. As OG are just absolutely shredding them here in game two, 21-9.
Yeah, that's some great aggressive play. It's the same story, just this time different player. It was not Notel going in balls deep. It was S4 just saying, well, I'll just go into whatever fight. I know I've got this Earth Spirit God behind me. He'll bail me out if I need. And Jerix is there once again, hitting the stun silences. There's a reason you can first two pick this hero when you've got Jerix on your team. And OG in a great position now. They're going to go for another Shrine. The uptime of this OG team, you think they just fought you and they've got to fall back, heal, wait for cooldowns. Now they Shrine up, they just turn around. They're not really playing around long cooldowns. Longest one they're really playing around is like maybe 60 seconds on the Shadow Dance. They've got a 50 second on Jewel. These are very short cooldown key spells for them.
So, I mean, we're sitting with this blink deck here. Gets Glimpse back, but immediately going back in. The Flame Break again knocking him out of the kinetic field. Being turned around upon him and falling down low. Jerax, is he going to hit anyone though with the Boulder Smash? But he does force them to split. Ramsey's trying to turn, finish off Notel, but the damage isn't quite enough. Jerax just staying on the front lines here, now rolls out. He goes with the kickback again, hitting three with the Boulder Smash. Notel, they found Ramsey's. The change from Anna onto two is a triple kill for S4, as once again, VP, they are just not being able to hold out against OG in these team fights. Each and every time, I'm seeing people on VP die, but I'm not seeing anyone on OG die, gods.
I just can't believe how many times a game Jerix hits like these three-man stuns and silences. Like, he does it without a blink dagger. He's going to have a blink soon, which makes it even easier. He just rolls into position to line them up, and it's incredible. It's one of these things, like, I don't want to keep talking about it, but it really is just such impressive play coming out from Jerix. And I mean, the frontline initiators from OG have, you can see really the trust in this team. They know that they're going to get the backup they need. Notel goes in into five heroes. He gets very low. He gets brought down. He then, his Shadow Dance wears off and suddenly he's being lassoed, but S4 is there to bail him out with a press the attack. Everyone is kind of on the same page with OG, and that page is very much run at VP. Overwhelm them. Don't give them any breathing room. Don't give them time to catch up. Don't give Drow any space whatsoever to farm. And VP, they're struggling right now. They are drowning with very little room to farm on their map. Drow's sitting at 5k. Drow is less farm than the Earth Spirit.
I managed to catch out S4 here. Bringing him out. And the Pasha blowing the epicenter. Make sure he gets the kill. There'll be a swap back. Pasha brought out to the side here. And they have caught him. So they will make him pay for that. Do you find a trade, and I mean, a one for one at this stage, VP will certainly take it. Putting an end to quite a streak that S4 was on. And money going to no one as well, so certainly will appreciate that on this Invoker. Getting himself a nice bit of a cash boost.
He's pinging out the ward, he knows where it is. It's one of those tough games where you're behind, the opposing team's playing super aggressive, and they have a Slark, so they're going to be able to deward all your vision.
Jerax again, immediately with the smash and the silence onto no one with Anna. Once more, I mean, he felt he was safe, no one, with that vision, but...
He had the obs, but...
Jerax.
So did OG. Both teams had the obs, and he got hit by the stun silence at just the worst possible time. I think at this point, VP definitely going to be a little bit tilted by what this Earth Spirit is doing to them.
It's just dancing around them. 3-1-15. It's an incredible game for Jax. Yep. I mean, not that we'd expect much less from him. He'd on his Earth Spirit, he's already shown it a few times today, but this showing here in this game up against VP, you know, a team considered to be one of the strongest at the moment, but OG certainly seeming to make the flaws of VP's lineup apparent with this performance.
Notel's now going to potentially have an Aegis. He's got the BKB. So when he goes charging in, he doesn't even have to worry about the Gloom, Static Storm, the Burrow Strikes anymore. He can just immediately pop a BKB, kill a Disruptor if he really wants to. And he needs to be a little bit careful this top lane. This Orchid is a bit of a problem on him, but he's going to have the solution soon. Once this Mantis style is complete, this Orchid is going to be largely negated. No Tail's going to BKB, Ember will have a Manta, both core heroes will have an escape. Not to mention there's Press the Attack from the support, well, the potential support of the Legion Commander. Not that he is a support. Jarex, he's perhaps got this kill.
He wants to go for it.
And he may just have it here with the silence and the magnetize. It looks like Solo turning over is going to force Jarex to hold back.
Forced him back at least, but lane's pushing at mid and bottom. Not sure there's much more OG can do here other than just maintain map control, get some wards down, deny some wards. Ideally, they want to push up both this bottom and mid lane. Yeah, there's lines being drawn down bottom by Notel. He's headed down there.
Radiant's bottom tower
realizing
is under attack.
This is not the time to make some plays. Ramzes has a Shadow Blade.
Let's see if he can do anything here to help his friend Lil. And it looks like the answer is no. He's like, I'm out of here, Lil. You're left for dead. And then Jarex once again picking up another.
Bat is not very farmed.
Okay, no one. Running Anna. Has he got the damage here during the duration of the Orchid? No, doesn't look like he does. And we've got to be careful on the side, Jarex. Won't connect on the smash. He's hunting for Solo. Pasha comes with a burrow. Solo, yeah, kind of looks at it, but he doesn't really want to turn as he knows that there's definitely more behind on this push in the mid. Ramzes just desperately trying to find anywhere on the map to farm. We're seeing him kind of sneaking from camp to camp in OG's jungle, hiding in the trees, doing his best to not be kind of caught out.
It's the best thing you can do. It's the smart play, but it's not the kind of play that's necessarily going to win you the game. And I think they have a pretty good idea. They're drawing lines like, hey, this is where the Drow's been playing, like, and outside of the map. I can only imagine they're like, hey, Drow's taking this kind of pathway. You can swoop through that mid lane with the Shadow Blade, but they're not going to waste time chasing around a Drow they may or may not catch. And there's no need to catch that Drow. That Drow is already being crippled. Drow is knocking me out of to fight all of a sudden just because she farms a couple of neutral camps on the radiant side of the map.
Here we have OG once again with a push, looking to take the final tier 2 away from VP. And he's just continuing to find what he can. Notel has the Basher on its way out, ready for the next fight. Immediate TP's coming out towards the top. Ramzes is just got to hope that they don't see him. Well, surprise, surprise, Jarex has a gem. And the two of them take him down. More damage in the pocket of S4, 72.
They want to punish at bottom, though. They know these heroes have been left a little bit alone. That's a TP onto a shrine. That's a feed, though.
Fly. No telling, Anna. 29-10. VP just continuously just struggling to kind of just get a hold on this game.
Yeah.
Or any sort of team fight. It just seems that OG are too far ahead. The VP are playing this Drow strat with the Drow absolutely crushed in the laning stage. And it feels like there's very little they can do at this point of the game. You know, a lot of it's down to no one. Maybe he can set something up. He's in the best shape on the side of VP, but it's still not great.
The Orchid is such a kind of wasted investment now because of the escape from both the Ember Spirit that's going to be just in a couple hundred gold, as well as the Slack. So this Orchid, he's just not going to get value out of. And I mean, to kind of really explain what's happening to VP now, they have no vision. They can't get vision because there's this gem and the Slack. Slack is just being an observer ward detector. Everywhere he goes, he just lets his team know if there's a ward there, thanks to the Shadow Dance kind of revealing where they can be. And at top, this is the kill with the Orca they need to get. Drake's there, ready to turn it around, though.
And indeed he does. Straight in with the combo. Ramses has the guts to hold them back. Buy some time for no one, but S4 immediately in with the duel. No one throws out one more final tornado, but he's out. So's the Drow. OG once again shutting down both cores, and they're just going to tap it out. It's too much for VP. OG just absolutely destroying them here in game two. It was not pretty if you're a fan of VP, but it certainly was impressive if you're a fan of OG. And a great game for Earth Spirit fans to look back and just watch and study what Jarex was able to do at the start of that game. Because from the get-go, it kind of felt it was almost over just because of what Jarex was able to achieve with those early rotations.
Yeah, he was very, very impressive. Got a lot of levels early on. All that aggression around the top lane, Fly even rotating up, gets the kill on the Batrider. The support's really the standout in the early game, and then you had the cores like delivering big. Notel was top of the net worth the entire game. He laned very well against Pashi. Did get that solo kill at that one point, but his CS was well above. I mean, Sand King had like 2 CS to his 20 CS at one point in what was a kind of 1v1. Venge was lurking around, wasn't spending that much time in the lane. So everyone on OG played a very, very impressive game here.
Absolutely, and yeah, OG with that series. Moving on, VP, we will still see them, but they'll be knocked down to the best of ones. So OG can go home tonight feeling pretty happy with that performance, and they certainly had an answer for the VP Drow. Ramses having a very tough old time there, and a lot of it just down to OG's core team play and early rotations. But that's it from myself and Gods. We'll be able to head back to the analysts now to hear what they have to say about OG's performance and VP's a little few troubles there in game two.
Yeah, thank you very much, OD and Gods, and indeed, it is OG that move on, and they don't just move on, no, they're now guaranteed top three of the tournament. What a showing. I mean, game one, we talked about it, was very even, and then they come back with game two.
OG is just ridiculously good.
Jarex is ridiculously good.
I think in the draft, too. I wasn't really sure how it was going to work out together for them, but they switched things up a little bit, and everything just came together for them.
I feel like that Batrider pick kind of opened the door for them as well. Like, the second you go for that Batrider into the four roll, you can see him go, okay, well, we can now run an aggressive tri lane. We can go full-on suicidal, and if we shut down the Drow Ranger and we attack the Drow Ranger under the T1 tower, who is going to stop us? A Batrider at level 1, level 2?
They needed a dodge. They needed to put the Drow Ranger in the bottom lane with 1 and then sack the top lane, but they weren't able to read the lanes in time. Maybe some early better observer wardage would have been better for VP, but they just got outplayed, outclassed today.
They really did.
They really did, and it has been a very long day for them as well as for us, as well as for you guys watching. We have a lot more games in store for you, but not today, thank God. We have more games in store for you tomorrow, where we will see Evil Geniuses going up against Team Faceless and Digital Chaos versus Team Secret. I guess that's the one that a lot of people are looking forward to. But you're going to have to wait for day two of the G2A.com Dota Pit Season 5. So we'll see you guys tomorrow.
Bye.